another alleged predator, let's put up a picture full of mass, 38 years of age, school teacher at a private Christian high school in the state of Florida, was arrested last week and charged with second degree felony after allegedly exchanging sexually explicit text messages with a student at the Christian Academy. Her name is Julie Kinsey Hoover. Ms. Hoover, a teacher at the Point of Grace Christian School in Perry, Florida, was taken into custody on Wednesday and charged with one count of an authority figure soliciting or engaging in sexual conduct with a student. The investigation into Ms. Hoover began when the mother of an 18-year-old at the school found a series of messages that had been exchanged between the child and Ms. Hoover. The mother contacted deputies at the Taylor County Sheriff's Office to report the messages. Per the report, the mother specifically found messages indicating that Hoover was planning, think about how diabolical this is, was planning to sneak her student into her home while her husband was at work. Okay? Sheriff's Office detectives reportedly found that Ms. Hoover and the teen began exchanging text messages in March of 2022 and continued through April. During that time period, the student was reportedly enrolled in more than one class taught by that school teacher. While the student in question was 18 years of age at the time of the alleged interactions, Florida law and a lot of other states as well, they prohibit adults who are employed by volunteering at or under contract with the school from soliciting or engaging in sexual conduct, a relationship of a romantic nature, or lewd conduct with the student. Hoover was released from custody at approximately 10:10 p.m. on a Thursday after posting a cash bond of $15,000. Now, let's put her picture up again. The school system, Point of Grace Christian School, they decided not to respond to messages from Law and Crime regarding Hoover's arrest, as well as her current state of employment. So they're saying no comment. Now, this is a clear moral, ethical, and legal breach here. There's an actual victim involved. And the school, the Christian Academy, has refused to provide leadership. We see something routine, especially with private institutions that have this kind of dynamic inside of their system. Typically, they try to protect the individual who's committing monstrous acts against students, or they cover it up. All right, Adrienne, thoughts on this?
I think that this is indicative of a larger problem, as we kind of discussed earlier, in terms of the predatory nature of women in these positions of power as educators who are developing these sexual and intimate relationships with students. I really think it's great to have these policies in place that no matter necessarily the student's age, whether they are an adult or of the legal age for consent in that state, that still that they can't have romantic relationships with teachers, because it is an abuse of power. There is a difference in the power between a student and a teacher, and it is so incredibly unacceptable. And so I just really hope that educators and administration will do a little bit more, because whatever's been done, it's clearly not necessarily enough, given that there are these continued instances.